Today on AE Test Drive, we're going to take the script Superlines for a spin. Superlines is available on the AE Script site, and it's a tool designed to make the process of generating multiple lines from shapes or paths, and with some efficiencies and style. It's being offered at $35 with bundled discounts available. So what does it do? As we can see, it's pretty trimmed down, not a lot of controls on it. And you'll find that it will default to this cartoon style. It comes one of two styles. One is cartoon and one is abstract. Now the cartoon style, I'm not going to demonstrate. It's pretty stripped down and basic. There's a lot more power that can be found in the abstract version. So we're just going to concentrate on that for this video. So I'm going to zoom out here. I'm going to draw a very quick path. And with that path selected in my composition, I'm going to leave it. Actually, I'll go up to 5 count. This is how many lines it's going to generate. We'll make it a round cap on the lines, and we'll say generate lines. And it does its magic. And if we just do a RAM preview, we can see that's most basic. It creates multiple lines based on that path. Nice. All right, that saves us a bit of time already. So you see what it also does is creates some pre-made animation for us, which of course we have complete access to. We can change at will. It's just a trim paths function with a start to end points offset from each other. And so if you go into the effect palette of that layer that's just been created, we do have some controls we can play around with. And we can change our width, get some random width going on, get into the position, change the position to separate them out a little bit. I'll take that down a bit. And a little more randomization. And change our positioning a little bit. And just by a few clicks, moving just a few of these parameters around, we got a totally different look going on. It's quite nice. Can be useful. Let's change the color. Actually, what we'll do is we'll change it to... It doesn't really matter. Something light. There we go. Easy enough. It's a global color change. And we have dash settings available. So we can get in, change our gap rotation, and randomness. There we go. And now we have some additional looks that we can work with. You can do something like duplicate your original layer, go to the control of the first one, take the dashes off, let's zero these out. And now we'll have dashes that sort of follow the original line. And we can color the dots a little bit differently. The color settings make them a little bit darker. So you see, just by playing around with a few settings, we get some pretty interesting looks fairly quickly. And so it is a time saver. It does save us from having to go into, and I'll maximize this and show you under the hood a lot of expressions. So this script does create a lot of expressions, linking a lot of different things to each other. It creates a lot of different shapes inside of the shape layer. So with this many expressions, of course, it's going to slog down the computer a little bit. If you get above 10, 12, 15 different shapes rather than the 5 count that we did, you're going to find it is going to slow things down. It's going to slow your RAM preview down a little bit until it caches it. But we get some interesting looks fairly quickly for minimal effort, which is good. We always like to do that. We're always looking for ways to save time wherever we can. Now, in building upon that, they also have a rotational parameter in here, which once again can really affect nicely your design and give you some randomness to this. I'll leave the dash alone for now. And I'm going to change the color to more of a... And there we go. Something chartreuse. Okay, so we have this motion going on. We can separate them out just a little bit with our position, just so we can see them a little bit better. What I found by playing around with this, if we start by pile some effects on top of it. So let's say we can go to Turbulent Displacement. Now things can start to get a little interesting. We play around with a few of these parameters. We ran preview it. Now we're starting to see something that looks a little more hand-drawn. Just once again, with minimal effort, we can create something that is starting to look interesting. In addition, we can go into, I'll maximize this once again, we can go in and change the colors of a few of these. If we turn off the expression here, let's make it a little more golden in color. There we go. And I think I'll change one more to that same color, turn off its expression. And now when we go back, now we have something that's getting even more interesting. And you can play around with these, play around with the displacement a little bit more, different kinds of displacement. Try a bulge, see what it looks like. Once again, it's just all a matter of play. So it's a tool to get you started, minimizes part of the work of having to create all these and with repeaters and offsetting the time, that sort of thing. So it's built under the hood. It's got that sort of system that's built in, which is nice. Now, this is where the tool starts to get even more powerful and more interesting. So let's just have a basic circle, and it's moving from left to right. Very basic, with some easy keyframes. Now, under super lines, we were hitting generate lines here, but there is another box, which is apply to position. So if you've got two or more position keyframes, this script will create multiple lines that follow those positions. So to see that in action, all we need to do is hit apply to position. It does its work. And now, if we were to do a RAM preview right now, you won't see anything because the script automatically creates the new shape layer underneath at the bottom of the comp. So it's below my background at the moment. So we just need to bring it above my background. Let's play a RAM preview. And there you go. It's creating motion lines for us automatically based on those position keyframes. Obviously, we want to change the color of those. Easy enough to do with those motion lines shape layer selected. Go into the color settings. We'll just color pick this. And let's also just change the width to it. And randomize the width a little bit. And adjust the position a little bit. I just want to widen it out just a bit. There you go. And so creates a very, very quick effect, follows the motion. And you can imagine just with a few more experimentation, how much more complex this can get. One of the things I would like to see this script in the 2.0 version is if I decide that that motion wasn't great, I wanted to have a little bit of incline to that ball. The script won't update. There is no update dialog box that would recognize that the position has changed and recalculate to follow this. So unfortunately, it's kind of baked in and you're kind of locked into the position at that point. You'd have to redo it at this point. Not a huge deal. So how can we take this further? Well, let's just say we have a circle here and we want to do some sort of action on it. So let's say that we use, I'll go to my expressions here. I'm going to use a throw expression. Select my position, use the throw expression. Now when we do a RAM preview. So there you go. You got a throw expression going on here. So what we need to do is, as I mentioned, Superlines looks for position keyframes. Well, because this is an expression, there are no keyframes. So we need to select this position, go to Animation, Keyframe Assistant, Convert Expression to Keyframes. Now we have keyframes all set based on that, what that expression has done. So now with that layer selected, we'll leave the defaults here. Apply to position and bring the layer above the background so we'll be able to see it. Let's change the color before we even take a look at it to yellow. Which settings a little bit there. Now you can see we have some interesting effects. So very nice, and you could once again play with this even further. Once again, let's add some Turbulent Displacement on here and see what it does for us. So you can see that it's not running in real time. It's now it's starting to run real time. So it is slow, a little bit slow, because there is a lot going on. If I keep on increasing this, you can see we're getting quite a interesting animated effect going on here. Almost to the point of being like a mercury or a liquid. I'm sure if we played around with this even more, we'd be able to get there. And you could also then pre-comp this and apply some beveling, for example, or some highlight. And it starts to get very, very interesting very quickly. One other thing we could do with this, let's take just a simple circle and let's apply a wiggle to it. And let's make this, let's leave that at 5 and 1,000. Well, yeah, okay. So the wiggle amount is pretty high, it's 5 and 1,000. So if we ran preview of that, it's running all over the place. So we're going to do the same sort of thing here. We're going to select a position. We're going to go to keyframe assistant, convert expression to keyframes. Now we have all these motion paths going on here that Superlines is going to pick up on. Apply to position. There we go. We'll bring it up above. I'm going to turn off the circle layer because I just want to see these effects here. I'm going to turn off the pass. So, interesting sketchy lines going on. But we could then apply some more interest to it. I'm going to copy these two effects that I had created earlier and apply it to this layer. Now we get animated sketch lines, which can be really, really handy. If we found a way to control the paths in such a way, we can do animated smoke quite easily. So you see, it's creating very interesting effects if you start piling some things on and start pushing the boundaries of what it can do at its most basic form. In addition, you can take things like text, for example. We can take our text, turn them into shapes by using like Text Exploder. So we select that, turn off our original. We're going to create shapes from text on all of these. And then go to Superlines and we can generate the lines on that. It automatically creates keyframes for us on a trim paths. Which is nice. And if you continue to play with it, you can create design styles that could look like this. So in a nutshell, this script is quite useful. Make your life a little easier, save yourself some time from doing some of the mundane tasks that you don't need to do, but at the same time, giving you some control over being able to modify it and create your own designs and styles.